Get ready to match the stars from MASH. Gary Berghoff, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Meg Bennett, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn!
Hello, Gene. How are you? Thank you very much. We thank you for joining us, and we thank you for joining us, too. Is everybody ready to have a fun and game here?
Yes.
You all ready?
Yes, sir.
Good. All right. Shall we get right to it, then?
Yes, sir.
All right. Let's say hello
to
the current champ here, Marcy Schneidmiller.
Applause, applause, applause.
When the time expired last time, Marcy had just won a game, so all she has is $100. However, it gives her the opportunity to now to play for over $5,000. You ready for that, Marcy?
Ready, ready.
All right, we'll do that right after we do this, especially for you. Do we make a lovely couple? We're both in brown, I just noticed there. Okay, you ready, Marcy?
Ready, ready.
For what?
This.
Okay, here it is. It's all for you. Not too long ago, we pulled a bunch in the studio and we said, write down your best answer to this, MASH blank. Now, if you match the answer they gave us most often, you will get another $500. If you match their second most popular answer, you'll get $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. And three of our six celebrities are going to help you.
Richard, please.
Mashed potatoes.
All right, sir, there's one.
Charles?
You got me, hon. Wait a minute.
Well, okay, Gary's television show, but I'm trying to figure it out. What night are you on, Gary?
Well, if I tell you, will you promise not to pick me next?
Okay.
We're on Tuesday nights.
Just talk it over. Take it.
Well, MASH TV show.
MASH TV
pick
show.
Me.
And mashed potatoes has an ED.
Yeah, that's all right.
The whole thing is a mess.
Matt, okay. Now, this is it. This is something that's just going to be wonderful.
He's got one for
it's
you.
It's just not, no. I don't even know what that is.
That's because you don't watch our show.
Get yourself prepared, folks. Mashed turnips.
I'm sorry. I'm an Emmy winner. I don't have to take this out.
Sit down there.
There are no country people out there. If there were, they'd know about mashed turnips.
Anyway, you got mashed turnips, mashed potatoes, and MASH TV show. Now,
this is a mess.
At this point, you can choose one of those, Marcy, or you may think up one of your own that they haven't been able to think of. What is your pleasure?
I thought of mashed potatoes, too.
You want mashed potatoes?
What a terrible
right.
choice.
I think that's the answer.
We'll find out what's up there right now. I'm just as curious as you are. Let's reveal a $100 response. Mash it.
Oh, I don't think this is going to relate to my show at all.
Yeah. All right. I don't know what that means. But as I said earlier, we had these weirdos in the studio audience. And we said, write down your answers. So they did. Here's the next one.
Turnips. There.
Mash 4077.
That's what I was trying to tell her.
Yeah, that's the medical.
What is that?
Medical. Now, wait a minute. Military.
Mobile.
Army. Mobile Army.
Surgical
Hospital.
But,
and it
gee,
was
that's
designated
terrific,
number 4077.
The question is a loser, no matter how much you're going to talk. It's laying there.
You know what? I agree with you. All right, maybe see the big one, please.
Yay! Congratulations, my dear. Pick up another
$500. And as Brett pointed out earlier, it is indeed mashed potatoes. But as I said, we had these dummies in here, and we put this questionnaire to them. We said, anyway, now you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000, Marcy, and we want to give you that money. But we can't do it to you until you match one celebrity exactly. You've got to choose one now.
Richard, please.
Okay, here we go. Stand on the blue dot there. Here it is, worth $5,000. Good luck to you, my dear.
Oh, thank you.
Got your ESP going over to him?
I think so.
He's got his ESP going to you then. Games blank. That's G-A-M-E-S blank. Games blank. Now, Marcy, we want the answer Richard has written on the card, and if you give us that, we give you $5,000. Games.
People play.
games people play. All right. We'll find out right now if that does get you the $5,000 or not. Richard?
I was thinking of the store where I get my backgammon set, where people...
$5,600.
You're stopping the flow of my blood there.
All right, good luck to you, Mike. $5,600. Let's meet another play now. Here comes Kenneth Yaw. Kenneth Yaw. Hello there.
Hey, Kenneth.
Okay, Marcy, you have a seat. Kenneth, you know Marcy Schneidmiller?
I sure do.
You sure do.
Right.
She's very happy and excited,
and we'll give her
a chance to cool down a little bit now while
that's
we find
wonderful.
Out who you are, Kenneth. Do you know who you are?
I don't know, Gene.
Well, we'll find out.
I'm retired from the postal department in Costa Mesa, California, and I've been married 41 years to the little lady right out here in the front row.
Yeah.
And originally we're from Hammond, Indiana.
Uh-huh.
And I brought my sister-in-law along for a little company.
Well, we're delighted to meet you, and I'll say hello to your wife a little bit later.
Thank you.
And good luck to you, Kenneth. We've got to do a little business with America, and then we'll start this game. Okay with you? All right. Come right back now and see how we do here. Let us begin at the beginning here. They polished this whole thing. It looks so nice now. All right. Kenneth, you may have A or B.
Try A.
You want to try A?
Try A.
You sure?
Try.
All right. Here it is. Hey, very few people know this.
Yeah.
But if you eat enough oranges, it'll make you turn blank. If you eat enough oranges, it'll make you turn blank.
I will if you do. Are you changing it?
No.
Oh, okay.
Put something down on the card, and we'll get on with it if you will.
Please,
let's get on.
Grinding his teeth in desperation.
Kenneth Yaw, you say you're from Hammond, Indiana, originally, eh?
Right on.
Yeah, where do you live now? Now you live in Costa Mesa.
Costa Mesa, California, right.
All right, here it is, Kenneth. As soon as Charles is ready. I don't see his pen moving. Now it is. Very few people know this, Kenneth, but if you eat enough oranges, it'll make you turn blank.
Well, the general answer would be, I'll say orange.
You'll say orange.
Orange.
They could turn orange.
They'd turn orange if you eat enough oranges.
I suppose so. He says if you eat enough oranges, it'll make you turn orange.
And you said very few people know this, right?
Yeah, right.
Just Anita and me. I said gay.
Gay. What are you laughing at, Kenneth?
And after all these years, 41 years.
41 years. You're still eating oranges and you haven't changed yet. Okay.
Carrots make you turn orange.
Carrots make you turn orange, right?
But oranges, I'll tell you what they do to you. All you little orange eaters, watch out. Gay.
Okay. All right.
I have never used my celebrity for political statements or for stands in various whatever.
Yes.
Orange.
Orange. And don't you wish you had? Orange, no, that gives Kenneth one match, so that's fine. Now, Meg, we're up to you. If you eat enough oranges, it'll make you turn...
Orange.
Orange. Good for you, Kenneth. What do you have to say?
Well, Gary's right, of course. That is Anita's theory.
Oh, it is?
I was playing cards with Anita Bryant last week. It's very difficult. She keeps tearing up the queens. I said, gay.
What do you say, Finn?
Well, I immediately thought of orange.
Orange?
Yeah.
Three. Okay. He did pretty well with his first round.
I know.
A little unusual there, Marcy. Now you've got to get going here. The sergeant said to the privates, this is the sergeant speaking to the privates. He says, okay, you guys, I got good news and bad news. The good news is you're all getting a furlough. And the bad news is you'll be spending it in blank. Sergeant speaking to them.
I love your accent.
Says,
so
I got good news and bad news, you guys. The good news is you're all getting a furlough.
What are they, in the Army, the Navy, or what?
They're in the Army, dummy.
All right.
They're not sergeants in the Navy.
He doesn't pay attention.
What's a furlough?
Furlough is a vacation.
Oh, I get it.
That he did.
All right, they're getting a furlough.
They're all getting a furlough, but the bad news is you'll be spending it in blank.
I get it.
Well, that's...
Oh, yes, of course. Oh, yes, 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 yes.
I shouldn't have showed it to you. You didn't even know what it meant.
What is he doing?
He's vamping till ready.
No, we're vamping till he's ready.
You couldn't have picked a better.
Think about it now, Mars. Okay. Finished? Yes, he's finished. Sergeant said to the privates. He said, okay, you guys, I got good news and I've got bad news for you. The good news is you're all getting a furlough, and the bad news is you'll be spending it in blank.
Boot camp?
Boot camp. So it means they won't be able to leave the camp at all,
right?
Huh? All right. Nah.
Sounds like the chorus from 2001 Space Odyssey.
Right? Right. What did you say?
I said in action.
In action.
Right.
You don't like that one either. When we get to one you like, you will let us know, won't you? Thank you. What do you say? You think you got one?
I think it's the definitive answer. Jail!
Bye, Joe.
You might at least look alert.
I don't know. I don't think there is any good definitive answer to this one. What do you say?
Detroit.
What am I doing in Detroit? Okay, Meg. Show and tell.
Well, I thought boot camp, but I wrote Army.
You'll be spending it in the Army. It ain't going nowhere, is what, according to you.
So you have good news and bad news.
Got good news and bad news. Good news is you're getting a furlough or a vacation. Uh-huh. The bad news is you'll be spending it in...
Guam.
Guam. That is bad. That would be... Well, no. That'd be worse. Would that be worse than Detroit?
Worse than Burbank.
Worse than Burbank, yes. What do you say?
Well, I tried to use the Army terms in the brig.
In the brig.
Brig.
Or jail. So in effect, we had two of those. There we are at the end of round one, 3-0 in favor of the challenger. Round two coming up after this. All right. We were just having a brief discussion of the coloratura role in Puccini's La Bohème. Now, we will carry on here with round two. And, Kenneth, you have a choice again of A or B.
A again.
A again. Here it is. Three people play. Gary, Brett, and Richard. Here it is. The bionic man said, yesterday they sent the bionic woman back to the shop. Her bionic blanks fell off. Look at Kenneth Yaw wrecking his brain here to think of an answer. Now, Kenneth, just listen carefully now. Stop the music. His brain works better when there ain't no music playing there. The bionic man said, yesterday they sent the bionic woman back to the shop. Her bionic blanks fell off.
Her bionic boobs fell off.
Yeah.
Her arms are bionic too, you know.
Why didn't you say arms?
Well, because I thought boobs might be a definitive answer.
But arms is your first choice.
Yeah.
Now, you know what we tell you here. Trust your first judgment, your first choice.
But
you said boobs, so that has to be your official answer. Arms was his first choice.
Boobs is his first choice. 41 years. Boobs.
There it is. We got one. You say arms, this legs,
question.
Eyelashes.
I thought of all of those, and then I thought, well, now this may be a match, I'm not sure. I said booberettas.
Booberettas. All right. Now you're up to five, Kenneth. Richard, what occurred to you? I know it was difficult for you.
It was. First thing I thought of was arms.
You did?
Yes. Being an armed man.
Yes. Now, Marcy. Marcy, you got to match Mercy, Marcy. You're in a heap of trouble here.
I know.
He in a catbird seat. You just one miss here and you're finished.
I've had it.
So listen carefully now. Now, you've all heard the story about the beautiful fairy princess who kissed the frog. Remember that story, Marcy?
Yeah,
yes, it was a beautiful story. Well, there was also an ugly princess. Now, she was so ugly when she... If you can be half-hearted, lay out. If you're going to do it, do it. She was so ugly...
Was she?
A slight improvement. When she kissed the frog blanked. Right, attaboy.
Gotcha.
Everybody plays.
See.
Okay. Hello, Marcy.
Hello.
Now, you've heard this beautiful fairy story about the princess who kissed the frog, and there was also an ugly princess. She was so ugly when she kissed the frog blanked.
Croaked.
Croaked.
Very good.
She not only got the right answer, but she got a little attempted humor we were making there.
Croaked.
Croaked it is. One for her. Gotta match everybody, Marcy. Need six dead frogs is what you need. Yeah. What do you say?
I say better red than dead. Croak.
Gonna have you investigated. What do you say? Well,
I just want to plug my Christmas special, The Gay Orange Frog from Guam. Unique story, croaked.
Oh. Score is now 6-3. If you match the celebrities on the lower tier, you'll end up in a tie here. Okay, Meg, we're up to you. What happened to that little frog?
I hope this counts. He died?
Died. Yes, he died. 6-4 to score. Looking for a dead frog.
Ribbit.
There's another one. 6-5. They're rooting for you, Fanny.
I understand
but
that.
I point out to Marcy, as in everything in life, there's good news and bad news. Right. Life is not all a bed of roses. We never promised you a rose garden, Marcy, did we, Fanny?
No, just warts and croaked.
Okay, we got it. High score. So, got a 6-6 tie here. Now, here's what happens when we have a tie. We push a little button here, reveal one tie-breaking question for each. The one who's matched the most will be the winner. Kenneth, you want... well, we'll turn the lights out, too. You may have A or B.
Try A.
A it is. Here it is. Harry said it's true what they say about a dog taking on its master's personality. Every night, my wife's dog has a blank. It's true what they say about a dog taking on its master's personality. Every night, my wife's dog has a blank.
I don't want your answer finished.
Hello, Kenneth. Harry said it's true what they say about a dog taking on its master's personality. Every night, my wife's dog has a blank.
Has a headache.
You got it. Very good, Kenneth. He's right on the ball there.
Boy,
good answer.
41 years, he should know.
Yeah. Show him your headache,
you
Harry.
Imagine how many headaches that is. That's incredible. No, you know, that's a good answer, and I should have said it. I'm
you
sorry.
Didn't say
no,
that?
It's terrible.
What did you say?
I said a tantrum.
A tantrum?
Yeah.
Really?
Well, I apologized.
The Pathetic Revealing Answer Award, what is that?
I'm an unmarried woman. I said fit.
A fit. Fitter tantrum, Chuck, looking for a headache.
Headache.
Came to the right place. There's one headache. Kenneth, looking for a headache here. You get one from Meg?
I said nightcap.
Nightcap. Will you give him a headache?
Bet I will.
There it is. Two headaches there. Fanny? Give him a headache. He's sweet.
Well, you know, he's so cute, I can't imagine your wife ever having a headache. Having a fit, but not a headache.
All right. So that's two for him, and we'll see how you do, Marcy. But right now, we got to stop and do some business with you. Join us next time, Magic Game. Goodbye. Bye.